A symbol of triumph and hope, Olivia Newton-John has had a lasting impact on millions of people around the world. And today, more than 2,000 gathered to say their final goodbye to Australia's sweetheart. Superstar friends and international co-stars, including John Travolta and Paul Hogan, are among those playing a part in her state memorial service, along with her family.
From the moment the doors opened, it was clear Olivia Newton-John was loved by so many.
Everything that was wholesome and good about Australia is what she represented.
She's just a beautiful human being.
We really loved her in movies.
Thousands gathering in Melbourne to celebrate a woman who was admired by generations all over the world.
Now, I had the honour of singing with her several times, and I considered her a great friend as well as a fellow entertainer. And Olivia, to quote one of your songs, I honestly love you.
Olivia's dearest friends and co-stars among those attending her state memorial service.
She was more than just music.
Absolutely adore.
I think right now, just looking at everybody coming together, it's going to be a very emotional day.
6 months after her death, some of the grief has started to subside, giving space to honour Olivia's life and achievements. Her husband and daughter leading the service, Sir Elton John and other celebrities paying tribute to Australia's sweetheart.
For the incredible fame that she achieved in her life, she was the most incredibly down-to-earth person you would ever meet.
Songs reminiscent of her past, filling the room with fond memories. Inside Hamer Hall, memorabilia to honour a career spanning six decades. A red gown worn by Olivia at the Royal Charity concert in front of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, and a gold record for Banks of the Ohio. Two special pieces for two special moments in her life.
Down by the
Olivia Newton-John was a woman of all seasons, a singer, songwriter, an actor, and in her later years, a philanthropist, after she was diagnosed with breast cancer.
You are fearful, and it is very frightening, but you have to make a decision that you're going to get through it.
Channeling her energy into creating the Olivia Newton-John Cancer Wellness and Research Centre, giving hope to others facing a similar struggle.
Oh, this is probably my biggest achievement, something I'm most proud of.
Her sunny smile and empathy endeared her to the world, standing room only for a final goodbye.
The memorial service is well underway inside Hamer Hall. There is about half an hour left before it wraps up, and we have just popped outside to the orange carpet, and you can probably tell orange is the colour of the night tonight, and that is because it was Olivia Newton-John's favourite colour, just another way of honouring the late icon. Many of the people down here today have described a bittersweet mix of emotions, sadness after losing someone who had such a huge impact on so many people, but happiness too, because it's hard not to smile thinking back to some of her best moments. You would have seen a star-studded list of Aussie celebrities make their way down the orange carpet, but most of the 2,500 people inside tonight are members of the public who pre-booked their tickets to secure their seats, some travelling from all over Australia to be here tonight, which just goes to show how loved Olivia was and how loved she still is. She was never one for the limelight, but tonight is all about her and remembering one remarkable Australian. Chris?
Thanks, Amber. Amber Johnston there, live from Melbourne.